Hello YouTubers and welcome to a new video of Arepas for Dinner. So for the ones who don't know me, my name is Andrea and I do what's for dinners, grocery hauls, travel blogs, blah blah blah, everything pretty much related to food. I live in the Czech Republic but I'm originally from Venezuela and I bring you with me everywhere where I go and I eat. In this video I'm bringing you back to my childhood. Well, not literally, I cannot take you to Venezuela, you know, I'm talking about my childhood, 1998, before Chavez, Maduro and all these communists came to power. But yeah, the thing is, I'm bringing you to a flavor that takes me back to my childhood, and that is
chicha!
Yes, chicha. What is chicha? I think chicha is not only from Venezuela, I think they call it horchata in Mexico as well, but I've never been to Mexico, I've never tried it, so I don't know if it's the same. Doesn't matter, I'm gonna talk about the Venezuelan chicha. What is chicha? Chicha is pretty much rice milk, but more like rice milkshake consistency. It's just this creamy, white, cinnamony sweet heaviness. So, to explain it a little bit better, it's just like a cream milk made out of rice. So it's completely vegan.
Not that I care. If you see my What's for Dinners, I eat all the meat that is there in the world for me to eat.
But if you are vegan, you might want to try this. To cook this, I think it took me a total of 40 minutes, and I did a very small batch, but you can do a much bigger batch because I think it's foreign friendly, so even if you're not Venezuelan, you are gonna love this recipe because my husband is Czech and he loved it. So I imagine, yeah, it's a very like...
Who doesn't like creamy, sweet things?
It's pretty much like a milkshake. It's delicious. I'm gonna tell a little bit of a story of what is chicha. So Venezuela has like some drinks, non-alcoholic drinks, that are like very remarkable for our country. And those are, I think the number one is Malta, the number two is chicha, and number three is cocada, in my opinion. Don't get offended. But for me, those are the non-alcoholic drinks that represent a Venezuelan person. And I think chicha is one of the ones that you can make at home, but actually, we're all living abroad, most of us at least, and nobody's actually making it at home, so, you know, why not? The person who, for me, made chicha, like, available to everyone on a daily basis was one guy, Go Juan, who invented a chicha stand called Juan Chichero. Juan Chichero was pretty much your food truck of chicha, in like a small version of food truck because it was my food. But it was pretty much amazing. That chicha, you could put some condensated milk on top and you could put cinnamon on top as well, even though chicha always has cinnamon, but yeah. And it pretty much just went everywhere, to the exits of the school, it went to the malls, it was in the squares, so pretty much every time you would see a Juan Chichero cart, you would buy some chicha because it was just the best chicha ever. So I asked my dad, I told my dad that I was missing chicha, and my dad is a great cook. He's not the one who cooks in my house, but he is like, he has his like staple recipes. And one of his staple recipes, you know, he has like barbecue is his staple recipe, he's the bread maker of the house, and as well, he has his own chicha recipe. But I try making it here in the Czech Republic because I can find ingredients everywhere. I mean,
cinnamon and rice, hello.
So yeah, I tried it and it's
the best
chicha I've ever had, and I think it could compete with Juan Chichero's chicha. So if you want to impress your Venezuelan friends, or if you want to try something besides an arepa, because yeah, we're more than an arepa, try this. I mean, it was legit the best chicha I've had. And before we start with the video, remember to subscribe, to like this video. I do videos like this all the time, so if you like this type of content, you are gonna love my channel. That's it, let's start with the video. Let's start by adding 1 cup of normal rice, not parboil, not jasmine, normal. And then soak it in 2.5 cups of water for 24 hours. 24 hours later, the rice will be softer. You could break it with your hands. To make sure it's creamy and smooth, we will blend it. First only the rice, or with the least amount of liquid possible. After blending it for 2 minutes straight, I began to incorporate the water and leave it to blend for 3 minutes on high. Once it's completely smooth, we will add it into the cooking pot and we will add some cinnamon. I added 1/2 teaspoon, but it's better if you can add 1 cinnamon stick instead. As well, add 1 teaspoon of vanilla and 1/2 cup of sugar. You could potentially use Splenda or Stevia instead, but I wanted to try the original recipe. Whisk it all together and let's cook this in low heat, moving it constantly. I opted for using this hand mixer with the first part and the rubber spoon for the second part. Make sure to move it at all times.
I changed to the rubber spoon. You can use a wooden spoon as well. Also, I had my temperature set to 5 over 10 for the beginning, and then I lowered it to 3 over 10. I was moving it around 30 minutes, and honestly, I felt like I burned all the calories the chicha has. But I think this is ready. This is the final consistency.
Oh my god, is this glue? What?
So now, for the last part, we will mix the rice paste with 1 cup of water in our blender.
So we are starting with 1 full cup.
You can add more or less water depending on how thick or thin you want it. So test the consistency. I had to add 1/2 cup more of water, for a total of 1.5 cups. I blend it in high for 2 full minutes. Serve it in a jar. You can use a smaller jar than the one I'm using. This was a monstrosity. Cool it down in the fridge like you would do with any milk. And that's it. Serve it over ice.
Mmm. Very good.
So that was it, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and to give this video a big thumbs up. And also, if you have anything like chicha in your country, tell me about it. If you know any other recipe like this that I could try here in my channel, let me know as well. This Friday, usually I post like What's for Dinners on Friday, but I actually posted my What's for Dinner on Tuesday. That was actually Monday because we're under quarantine. So, you know, I don't know what day it is. The days of the week are tomorrow, today, and yesterday, pretty much. And also, something curious before I finish the video. I don't know if you guys realize, but I'm a Catholic, and if you realize, Lent in Spanish is actually called Cuaresma, and we are in Cuaresma right now. That is pretty much almost the same word as quarantine. So today is Friday of Cuaresma under quarantine. So yeah, that's it. Go buy your rice, go do your chicha. Follow, subscribe, and thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you next Tuesday with a new video. Like always, Tuesdays and Fridays. Don't forget. Bye.